Hello, 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 everybody, and welcome to PrivateEnglishPortal.com. My name is Steve Ford, and today we are going to be talking about scary characters. Here in North America, children and adults like to wear costumes based on scary characters on Halloween and at other scary costume parties. The most popular scary characters are vampires, zombies, witches, and demons or devils. In popular culture, many movies have been made about Dracula, a charming man who lived or lives in his castle in Transylvania. In this case, many believe this vampire's name comes from Prince Vlad III from the 15th century in Romania. He lived there with three vampire women, woo, for centuries, as vampires do not get old. Vampires live off of the blood of humans and bite their necks. They're extremely seductive and can sweet talk just about anyone. Dracula was known for his ability to hypnotize his female victims by putting them into a trance, kind of like Transylvania, so that they would never suspect that he would eventually drink their blood. He could transform himself into a bat to fly long distances. His objective is always blood. That's blood, blood, I want to drink your blood. As soon as a victim was bitten by a vampire, the victim would become a vampire too. And Dracula's ambition was to slowly take over the world by turning everyone on the planet into vampires. But don't give up hope. Dracula can be defeated. Yes. He has his Achilles heel. Vampires do not cast a reflection in mirrors. They can be kept away by hanging garlic around the house. Their skin burns when it comes into contact with holy water. A vampire can be killed if a stake is driven through its heart while they are sleeping in the daytime. Vampires are afraid of crosses. Maybe you know someone who is a vampire in another way. They suck your finances dry. They suck your energy. Yes, some people take advantage of others. I know this. And we all need to be on guard against vampires in disguise. Psychological vampires. Have you ever noticed that after talking to some people, you feel like you've just run a marathon? You start, oh, it's nice talking to you, yawning, and feel like something or someone is dragging you down. Well, don't despair. You've probably been the victim of a psychological vampire. Now, what can you do to protect yourself? Some say crossing your arms helps. Okay. It shows that you are able to protect yourself from an attack. Zombies, a zombie Haitian Creole for zumbi. Yes, is an animated corpse brought back to life by mystical means. The term is often used figuratively to describe a hypnotized person lacking consciousness and self-awareness. Looking like a zombie is also used to describe someone who is completely spaced out, having a very empty look in their eyes. Oh man, you look so spaced out. You're a total zombie. A zombie has also become a popular term to represent those who follow something without questioning it. Yes, master. Doesn't matter what or who they are following. No, master. Yes, master. Witches. Witches have been a part of culture for a long, long time. Hundreds of years ago in Europe and the Americas, any kind of witchcraft was heresy and punishable by death. Witches were known to have special magical powers, and some were described to have the ability to cast spells on people, animals, change the weather, and so on and so forth. Some things commonly associated with witches are a broomstick, which they were said they could fly on, a cauldron to make witches brew, a boiling, steamy recipe made from strange ingredients to make magic potions to cast spells, 2 pinches of spider web, and 2 pinches of frog slime, etc. A witch's hat, a pointy black hat in a cone shape, and a rim, and a black dress. Many witches are famous for wearing black, and a black cat. Many witches are known to have a black cat who serves as their helper, their apprentice, and the witch is able to talk telepathically with her cat. Devils and demons, I've saved the worst for last, since many cultures the world over have the subjects of demons in their culture, and probably it's one of the hardest topics for people to even mention. All demons are unclean spirits or fallen angels, with the devil being their leader, their head honcho. Costumes for demons are typically with a red suit, horns, a tail,
and a trident,
and the face usually looks a little reptilian with accentuated eyes, pointy eyebrows, a protruding chin, sometimes with a pointed or a pointy black beard and or mustache, and last but not least, an evil smile or laugh. Demons are clever in that they can confuse with the choice of the words they use, telling half-truths, talking out of both sides of their mouth. They use doublespeak, hoping to deceive us. Should I have a piece of chocolate or a nice healthy apple? Decisions, decisions. Okay, everybody, that's it for me today. So let's do the Scary Characters Interactive Quiz, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.